Good morning. In today's lecture, we are discussing about AGMARK. Before discussing what is AGMARK, let's go through an introductory portion. The Directorate of Marketing and Inspection, which is known as DMI, was established in the year 1935 with an aim in welfare of agriculture as well as for the farmers. So they implement several agriculture marketing policies and also several programs for the development of the sector. Along with that, they safeguard the interest of all the farmers as well as the consumers. Besides, they also develop a close relationship between the central and the state governments. The directorate is headed by the Agriculture Marketing Advisor of India, and the headquarters is located at Haryana, that is mainly in Faridabad. The AGMARK has 11 regional offices at different states in India and 11 regional AGMARK laboratories, which is known as RALs, and one central AGMARK laboratory, which is known as CAL, and the CAL is located at Nagpur. Besides these, it also has 27 sub-offices and mainly Cochin, which I have specified earlier that it has 11 regional offices. So one office is present in Cochin in Kerala. It has both the office as well as the laboratory. So next, we are discussing about AGMARK. So AGMARK is the abbreviation of Agriculture Marketing. So it is also a quality certification mark under the Central Agriculture Produce or Grading and Marketing Act of 1937. The word AGMARK is derived from the combination of two words, that is AG and MARK. AG means it is agriculture and MARK means it is a certification. So Government of India has defined the AGMARK Certification Act in 1937. And the same act was amended in 1986 by passing bill in our parliament. Next, we have to discuss about the AGMARK label. So what do you mean by AGMARK label? It is a label specifying the name of commodity. So whichever product you are going to be marketed, it should have a specific name. So that it should be specified along with grade designation. So depending upon the quality of a product, several gradings will be provided by the AGMARK. So it has to be designated on the label, as well as it should bear a prescribed insignia, that means a logo. That is, you can see three logos here. That is the first logo, which is nowadays you will be able to see this logo more commonly rather than the other two logos. So ancient times or recent or just days before, the other two logos were being used. So in these two logos, that is in the two and third picture, you will be able to see a map of India with the word AGMARK inscribed vertically and horizontally, and a rising sun on one side and the words Bharatiya Utpad on the other side at its bottom. So basically, these logos or labels indicate the purity and quality of the product on the basis of the standards that have been laid down. The labels of different colors are used to indicate the grade of the product. So based upon the grade of the product, the color of the label may also change. The AGMARK label are printed on special quality paper and issued by the Agriculture Marketing Advisor. So AGMARK Act covers 205 different categories of agriculture products and commodities. It also include pulses, cereals, essential oils, vegetable oils, fruits and vegetables, and also certain special commodities or semi-processed commodities. So AGMARK certification is extremely important for all retailers and wholesalers across the country in order to sell their products to large base of customers. So AGMARK certification is compulsory for the following 8 food products. That is, the first one is blended edible vegetable oils. Second one, fat spread. So fat spread means it is a product in form of water in oil emulsion of an aqueous phase and a fat phase of edible oils and fats excluding animal body fats. So the third food product is Carvia callosa. Carvia callosa is basically a shrub found in the hills of Western Ghats on the west coast of India. So mainly honey is derived from these flowers, which blooms once in every 7 years. So the fourth one is the normal honey, which is obviously known. And the fifth one is ghee, having a less RM value. So RM value, it is Richard value. This value is an indicator of how much volatile fatty acids can be extracted from fat through saponification. The term saponification is already familiar to you. And also, a different standard for BR than that of specified for the area in which it is important for sale or storage. BR, it mainly used to measure the purity of the food items, basically the food items like ghee, sweets, fats and oil. So purity of these items is measured by using a accuracy test, that is using butyrorefractometer. So the short form of butyrorefractometer is BR. So the normal BR value of ghee is supposed to be 40 degrees centigrade. An increase in reading above this indicated value of ghee, it helps to understand that the ghee is adulterated with vegetable oil or animal body fat. The sixth one is til oil, produced in Tripura, Assam and West Bengal. Seventh food product is Kangra tea. That is a tea which is mainly obtained from the Kangra district in Himachal Pradesh. And the last one is light black pepper. So the next topic we are going to discuss is regarding the certificate of authorization. That is, the certificate is mainly given to the packers, authorizing them to grade their commodity under AGMARK. So the certificate will be valid up to 5 years. So for getting a certificate of authorization, we have to give a separate application for each commodity. So for each commodity, a separate application has to be produced. So after giving the application, the certificate of authorization will be issued after the due enquiry. So due enquiry means that upon submission of the application, the concerned officer of AGMARK shall inspect the premises of the applicant, and the applicant has to produce the true documents asked by the inspector. If inspector is satisfied with the certificates or the documents, he will forward it for the certificate of authorization. So here in this webpage, this is a webpage of Directorate of Marketing and Inspection. When you go through this webpage, you will be able to see the logo of AGMARK. Along with that, you will also be able to see the certificate of authorization, how you can do it online. And besides the act and rules, then about the AGMARK online system, how we can do the AGMARK, that is applying, how the procedure is, what are the commodities that we have to go for AGMARK certification, all those has been detailedly described in this webpage. So for your information, you can just refer to this website. Now I have already told that while giving the application, we have to follow some requirements. There are some requirements which has to be followed while giving an application. So that requirements are, we have to give the copies of test reports duly authenticated from independent AGMARK from recognized laboratory. Then there should be a document authenticating the establishment of the firm, then memorandum of the article in case applicant firm is a limited company, partnership deed, name of the products, name of the applicant, name of the firm or company, address, samples of the product, total gross product in kilogram for the past last year, turnover of last year. All these details should be attached along with our application form. So So the DMI, that is a certifying agency, also levies a negligible charges for issuing AGMARK labels to the packers. So it will be a negligible charges at basically 1.5 paise per kilogram or 20 paise per kilogram, like that. So this grading charges is obviously at a very low cost. So this low cost is being kept to ensure or encourage the manufacturers and producers to come forward for grading their products before marketing it. So you can just see again the examples for such things. Now you can see some examples. I had given some examples along with that. Is first one is ghee. You can see the AGMARK. It is AGMARK certified, so obviously the logo is specified. In second one also you can see the logo. If logo is there, it clearly said that it is certified, AGMARK certified. So this is an web page of Directorate of Marketing and Inspection. So again, you will be able to know more about AGMARK, AGMARKNet portal, rules and acts related to it. So for your further reference, you can just go through the web page. More information you will be getting. So this will be helpful for your future for getting more knowledge about the AGMARK. So these are the references. Obviously, I hope you all have understood the lecture. Thank you.